In this video, we will be discussing the Unit 3, that is AT51 microcontroller. The topics of Unit 3 are hardware architecture, in details of AT51 microcontroller, functional building blocks of AT51 microcontroller, memory organization, I/O ports and data transfer concept, timing diagram, interrupts, instruction set of AT51 microcontroller, under this data transfer, manipulation instructions, control algorithm and I/O instructions, comparison to programming concept with 8085 microprocessor. Let's see one by one. Introduction to microcontroller. First, what is microcontroller? Microcontroller is a semiconductor device manufactured by using VLSI or ULSI technology. VLSI means very large scale integrated device, that is more than 1 lakh components are fabricated on a single IC chip, that is called VLSI technology. ULSI means ultra large scale integrated IC chip, that is more than 1 million components are fabricated on a single IC chip, that is called ULSI technology. So microcontroller is a semiconductor chip manufactured by using VLSI or ULSI technology. It includes memory, serial and parallel I/O lines and timers, in addition with microprocessor as its CPU. All are fabricated on a single IC chip, that is called microcontroller. So this is the definition of microcontroller. Actually, microprocessor based system design requires microprocessor, memory, I/O ports and timers. Assembling of all these discrete components in PCB has the following disadvantages. The first one is expensive, second one large in size, third one not reliable, fourth one troubleshooting is difficult, fifth one high production time. So the problem of microprocessor based system design is overcome by the microcontroller. So microcontroller is a computer on a chip, that is microprocessor, ROM, RAM, parallel I/O, serial I/O and timers are integrated on a single chip, that is called microcontroller. According to the size of the data word, microcontroller is categorized as 4-bit microcontroller, 8-bit microcontroller, 16-bit microcontroller and 32-bit microcontroller and so on. The examples of 4-bit microcontrollers are Texas Instruments, that is TMS-1000, Hitachi HMCS-40. Then the examples of 8-bit microcontrollers are Motorola 6801, 6805 and MC68HC11, in addition with Zilla Z8 and Z86C83. So these are all examples of 8-bit microcontroller. In case of 16-bit microcontroller, some of the components are Texas Instruments, that is TMS-9940, okay, then NK68200, then Digital Equipments, LSI-11, Hitachi H8R532. So these are the 16-bit microcontroller components. Similarly, 32-bit microcontrollers have been developed by IBM and Motorola. MPC-505 is a 32-bit RISC-based microcontroller of Motorola. Then 403GA is a 32-bit RISC embedded controller of IBM. 32-bit microcontrollers are used for sophisticated control applications. So this is about history of microcontrollers. Then these are the features of AT51 microcontroller. The first feature is 8-bit CPU, that is 8-bit central processing unit. The second one, 21 special function registers. then 32 bidirectional I/O lines, then 64 kilobytes address space for program memory and 64 kilobytes address space for external data memory, then 4 kilobytes of ROM memory, okay, on-chip program memory, then 128 bytes on-chip data memory, that is RAM type, 4 register banks, then 16-bit timers or counters, then high-speed programmable serial port, then powerful bit processing capability, then 5 source interrupt structure. So these are all features of 8051 microcontroller. The next topic is comparison between microprocessor and microcontroller. The first difference between microprocessor and microcontroller is microprocessor is the heart of the computer system, whereas microcontroller is the heart of an embedded system. And second difference, it is a central processing unit on a single silicon-based integrated chip. The microcontroller is a byproduct of the development of microprocessors with a CPU along with other peripherals. The third difference between microprocessor and microcontroller are it is used for general purpose applications that allow you to handle load of data. Microcontroller is used for specific application system. Okay, then microprocessors are based on von Neumann architecture, whereas microcontroller are based on Harvard architecture. Then microprocessor based system requires more hardware. Microcontroller based system requires less hardware. Okay, then microprocessor is the only processor. Memory and I/O devices need to be connected externally, whereas microcontroller has a processor along with internal memory and I/O components. That is, memory and I/O has to be connected externally in case of microprocessor. In case of microcontroller, memory and I/O devices are built in on the same IC chip. It is mainly used in personal computers, whereas microcontrollers are used mainly in washing machines, MP3 players and embedded systems. Microprocessor has a smaller number of registers, so more operations are memory based, whereas microcontroller has more registers, hence the programs are easier to write. Then more time required to complete a process. This is about microprocessor. In case of microcontroller, less time required to complete a process. Okay, then more flexible for design. This is for microprocessor. Then less flexible for design. This is for microcontroller. Okay, then due to external components, the total power consumption is high. Therefore, it is not ideal for the devices running on stored power like batteries. In case of microcontroller, external components are low, so total power consumption is less, so it can be used with the devices running on stored power like batteries. Okay, then most of the microprocessors do not have power saving features. In case of microcontrollers, power saving features are available. So these are the difference between microprocessor and microcontrollers. Then these are the advantages of microcontrollers. Microcontroller has more advantages than microprocessor. The first advantage is small size. Second one, high speed of operation. Third one, easy to troubleshoot and maintain. Fourth one, more reliable operation. Fifth one, overall system cost is low. Then less power consumption. Then the microcontroller operates on 12 MHz clock frequency. Then microcontroller has powerful instruction set. That is, RISC-based instructions are available. Okay, RISC is nothing but reduced instruction set computer. Also, RISC-based instruction sets available in case of microcontrollers. So these are all advantages of microcontrollers. Then applications of microcontroller. Microcontrollers used in mobile phones, automobiles, CD or DVD players, washing machines, Xerox machines, traffic control, cameras, security alarms, keyboard controllers, microwave oven, watches, MP3 players. So these are all the applications of microcontrollers. So this is the block diagram of 8051 microcontroller. The 8051 is an 8-bit microcontroller. So the internal architecture of 8051 is shown here. There are four main blocks. The first one is internal row and 128 bytes of RAM memory. Okay, then four IO ports with the programmable pins. Then timers and counters. The fourth block is serial data communication. Actually, these four blocks are inbuilt in case of 8051 microcontroller. The advantages of built-in peripheral devices of microcontrollers are, built-in peripherals have smaller access time, hence speed is more, hardware reduces due to single chip microcomputer system, then less hardware, then reduces PCB size and increases reliability of the system. So these are all advantages of inbuilt peripheral devices of the microcontroller. The next diagram, that is architecture of 8051 microcontroller. The architecture consists of totally 15 blocks. Okay, the first one is ALU, second one accumulator register, third one B register, fourth one two temporary registers, temp 1 and temp 2. Okay, then fifth one program status word, that is PSW. Okay, then timing and control unit, then stack pointer, then program counter, then data pointer, then control registers, that is special function registers, SFR, then serial data buffer, then instruction register, then IO ports, totally 4 IO ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3, counters and timers, and last one is oscillator circuit. Okay, so totally 15 blocks available in architecture of 8051 microcontroller. See the first block, ALU, arithmetic logic unit. So arithmetic logic unit performs 8-bit arithmetic and logical operations over the operand held by the temporary registers, that is temp 1 and temp 2. These registers cannot be accessed by the users. Okay, that is a temporary register. Okay, so arithmetic logic unit performs arithmetic logical operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, increment, decrement, and or XOR, complement, compare, rotate instructions. Okay, using 8-bit words. The second one is general purpose registers. The 8051 contains 34 general purpose working registers. The registers are arranged as part of internal RAM in four bands, that is B0 to B3 of 8 registers. The remaining two are A and B register. So totally 32-bit bank registers. The 32-bit are arranged as four groups, bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. So the remaining two registers, one is called accumulator register, another one is called B register. Okay. The general purpose register, that is A and B, hold result of many instructions. Okay, hold the results of many instructions. Similarly, mathematical and logical operations of the 8051 central processing unit. Okay, activity. So the first one is A register or accumulator register. So it is a 8-bit register. It is also called register A. It is used to hold the data for many operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. It is also used for data transfer between 8051 and any external memory. So these are the functions of accumulator register. The second one, that is B register. Okay, so B register is used with the accumulator register for multiplication and division operation to store one of the operand. In other instructions, it may be used as scratch pad registers. Then third one, that is PSW, program status word or processor status word. The 8051 has two types of flags. They are MAC flag and general purpose user flag. Okay, the MAC flag consists of four flag registers. The first one carry, second one auxiliary carry, third one overflow, and last one is parity flag. Okay, so the 8051 has four MAC flag like carry, auxiliary carry, overflow and parity. Then general purpose user flag. These flags can be set to 1 or cleared to 0 by the user as desired. Okay, so programmer can use these flags to record some event in the program. There are three user flags, namely F0 in addition with GF0 and GF1. Okay, the user flag GF0 and GF1 are stored in PCON register, that is power control register. Then program or processor status word. So the PSW contains MAC flag, user program flag, that is F0, and the register select bits that identify which of the four general purpose register banks is currently in use by the program. Okay, see here RS0 and RS1. So this is called register bank select bits. If the two bits values, that is 00 means register bank 0 is selected. In case of 0 and 1, register bank 1 is selected. 10 means register bank 2 is selected. 11, register bank 3 is selected. Okay, so this is parity. Then first bit undefined. So this is used for future purpose. So this is overflow flag. Register select 0, register select 1. So these two bits used for to select the bank registers. Then F0, that is user defined flag. Then AC, that is auxiliary carry flag. Then CY, that is carry flag. Let's see the first bit, that is parity bit. Okay. In an arithmetic operation, if the result of accumulator contains odd number of ones, the parity flag is set. Otherwise, it is reset. So this is parity flag. Then overflow flag. In an arithmetic operation, if there is a carry out either in D7th bit or D6th bit of the accumulator, then the overflow flag is set, otherwise it is reset. That means actually the accumulator size is 8-bit. If the result is more than 8-bit means that time the overflow flag is set, otherwise it is reset. Then next one, auxiliary carry flag. Auxiliary carry flag is used in BCD arithmetic operations. This flag is set whenever a carry from D3 to D4 bit is obtained. Okay, so this flag is considered only for BCD addition. Otherwise, this status is ignored. The next one is carry flag. In an arithmetic operation, when carry is generated, the carry flag is set, that is CY equal to 1, otherwise it is reset. Okay, then F0, that is user defined flag or zero flag. This flag can be set or reset as per the user's choice. It is a user programmable flag register. Zero flag available to the user for use as a general purpose indicator. Okay, so this is about processor status work. Then the next one, so accumulator over, B register over, temporary register over, ALU over, program status work over. Okay, the next block is timing and control unit. The timing and control unit generates control signals for proper functioning of the system. Okay, this unit synchronizes all the operations with the clock pulse. So the timing and control unit generates clock signals for synchronization purpose. So the clock signal synchronizes the operation of microcontroller with the peripheral devices. That is the function of timing and control unit. Okay, the next one is stack pointer. Stack pointer is a 16-bit register. It is used to hold the internal RAM address, that is called the top of the stack. Stack pointer is incremented just before data is stored by using push or call instructions. So already you know the function of stack pointer. Okay. Then one more information, that is to retrieve the data from the stack, the stack pointer is decremented by 1. Okay. Then 8th block, that is program counter. Program counter is a 16-bit register used as memory pointer. It holds address of the next instruction to be executed is stored. Then the program counter is automatically incremented after every instruction is fetched. Then this is the only register that does not have any internal address. Okay. Then the next one is data pointer. Data pointer is a 16-bit register. It contains two 8-bit registers. One is data pointer high order register, another one data pointer low order register. Actually, this register is used to hold the 16-bit address during the addressing of external memory. So that is the function of data pointer. Okay. The next one, special function registers. So 8051 consists of 21 special function registers, that is SFR. Okay, the SFR used for specific functions and control of various blocks of 8051 microcontroller. The special function registers are, the first one is accumulator register, second one B register, then data pointer high order register, data pointer low order register, then interrupt enabled register, then interrupt priority register, port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, then power control register, processor or program status word, then serial control register, serial buffer register, then stack pointer, timer or counter mode register, timer or counter control register, then timer 0 low order register, timer 0 high order register, timer 1 low order register, timer 1 high order register. So totally 21 registers, special function registers available in case of 8051 microcontroller. The 8051 operations that do not use the internal, okay, 128 bytes of RAM, that is random access memory from 00 to 7F. Okay, the address range of special function register is 80 to FF. Okay, so this is about special function registers. The next one, serial data buffer. The 11th block is serial data buffer. That is, the serial data buffer is actually two separate registers. One is transmit buffer register, another one receiver buffer register. A transmit buffer register is used to hold the data for serial transmission. A receiver buffer register is used to hold the data for serial reception. Okay, so this is about serial data buffer. Next one, instruction register. That is the 12th block is instruction register. It is an 8-bit register. It is part of the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Okay, when an instruction is fetched from memory, it is loaded in the instruction register. Okay, then it determines the operation to be followed in executing the entire instruction. Okay, then 13th block is IO ports. The 8051 has 4 parallel IO ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. All ports are bidirectional. Each line consists of latch, an output drive and an input buffer. Then 14th block is counters and timers. The 8051 has 2 16-bit timers, that is timer 0 and timer 1. It will generate accurate time delay or can be used as external counter. Okay, the counters are divided into 2 8-bit registers, that is TH0, TL0, then TH1, TL1. All the counter actions are controlled by timer mode and timer control registers. Okay, then the last block, that is oscillator. 8051 has an inbuilt on-chip oscillator circuit. Here 2 pins, that is XTAL1 and XTAL2. Pins are used for connecting a resonant network from an oscillator. Okay, it is used for providing the clock to 8051 microcontroller, which decides the speed of operation or baud rate of the microcontroller. Okay, so this is about architecture of 8051 microcontroller.